this is my mini review of the Galaxy Nexus, which is filming this right here. I've heard many reviews, I've seen many blogs about the Galaxy Nexus and the positives and the cons. But I just want to say that coming from the Motorola Droid, the OG version, to the Galaxy Nexus is a big leap. It's a big jump, and a positive jump. I will say that, like everybody says, Ice Cream Sandwich is a really, really good operating system. It's very intuitive. It's very stylish. And I also want to say that the camera, which I've been hearing is very mediocre, it's a pretty good camera. It's not, you know, a bum camera. It takes very good pictures. Right now, I have no lights on. It's just natural light, and it's filming very well. The audio picks up very well. I have Pandora over here playing. Shaolin Channel. Check that out. Shaolin Radio. This is the video, and the regular camera does very well for a 5 megapixel. Which, if I'm correct, was the same thing as the OG Droid. But it takes very good pictures. It's not the most, it's not the best, but it's not like mediocre. I would say it's very good, especially for 5 megapixels. But of course, you don't have to look at. It's not the most megapixels make the best, make the cameras, the lens. So surprisingly, it does a very good job. What else is good about the screen? Is excellent. The stock Ice Cream Sandwich is actually a very good OS. I do like home screen changes, and I'm using Go Launcher. Yes, excellent home screen replacement. I love it. Has 3 docks. Runs very well. The widgets are excellent and awesome. You know, I just want to say that the Galaxy Nexus on a scale of I'm this is my first review, so I have to figure out a scale to give it. Doesn't say that it gets a very good. Is it the best machine ever created on God's green earth? That's to be said. But it is a very good change of pace of what I had previously. So it's a great a phone to have. And if you need an upgrade, I'd say upgrade to the Nexus. And no, it does not have a one thing. You can change the battery, unlike the Razr. Does have an SD card. No, it don't. It don't have an SD card. Sorry for that. Does not have an SD card, but that's all right. You get the full amount of storage, which you would get, and it's really not a big issue anyway. If you need to send something to your computer, you can send it by plugging into the computer, or you can find a program like Dropbox or any of the others, AirDrawer or something like that, to send your files to your computer. So that's not a big issue. But I'm going to start doing little reviews like this about stuff which I have at home. Maybe some companies get up with me, then I can start reviewing their products. But this is going to be my little thing which I'm doing. It's really going to be a different type of setup, because not just going to be doing reviews to have kids around. Not just going to be doing a review about a particular product, but it's all going to be a review about the product, but also about the culture that we're dealing with, that we're living in. Review of the culture, and especially from a Christ-centered or biblical theological perspective. So hope y'all dig it. Dealing about technology, culture, the scriptures, dealing about all those different things, and hopefully it'll be a cool thing people get up on. So let me get out for this, because my son Joel is destroying the house right now because I'm not watching him. And I can't wait till I get to the dentist, so I can plug up this tooth or teeth. I have a cavity, I don't know, it's just bugging me. But it's Joseph Elliott Banks, and I'm signing off. Grace and peace.